Big part of the push rod. There's a big part of the push rod. There's an inch and a half. There's an 2 inch. Still got part of the wrist pin stuck in it. We figure what happened is the wrist pin seized up and the piston quit rotating on top of the push rod. Blue. There's a rod, part of the rod cap. Here's the other part of the rod cap with part of the rod cap bolt and the push rod. Here's the other part of the push rod cap and bolt. Something I just noticed about this piece, what might have helped this motor come apart was this bolt ain't broke, the nuts backed off of it. See that?
Yeah.
Not a broken end, that's a stock factory end, and the bolt's gone, so it backed off. Yeah. This is a bearing, rod bearing. This is part of a piston. More piston. We blew Matthew DeLong's motor up in the 64 truck. Bad journal. The piston won't even come back out that direction anyway. That piston's all messed up. We blew it up, and since it's got blown up, we've had 6 or 7 different race people offer us parts. This one was not rebuildable, so we had Mark Mildrum give us a totally different block that all we gotta do is put our heads and intake on. All the guys up at Wildcat were willing to give us parts. Dave Etzel, Corey Bell. Want to thank them all. Trying to keep the trucks up running. These guys are all good guys. You gotta get into racing, folks, because there's not a better group of people. And now we got our hands full, because now I gotta pull all the parts off this to put on here and get back in there. We got our hands full for a day or two.
How many days you got left?
We got 8 days.
8 days.
8 days. Thanks for letting me drive your hot rod. So glad I could pull it off for you.
'Cause you think we can fix this?
No, I don't think we can fix this. Piston, folks. It should be about yay tall, but that's what's left of a piston. Okay, well, this is the old set of spun bearings in one cylinder that was getting ready to come apart. The ones in this cylinder came apart. We don't know where they're at. This is the one in the number 4 hole, and this is rings or bearings that were supposed to fit on the rod cap, and that rod cap bearing fits inside that spun bearing. So if you ever spin an engine like this, you might be able to get another set of bearings and just put it all back together. I wouldn't advise it, but you could do it if you're a redneck. Mainly this video is just to show some of the damage that can be done, but it's also to thank all the people that were concerned enough to help us get the truck back on its feet, and more of a thank you for all the parts and concern from all the other people that were willing to help put the truck back together so we could get back out with the rest of the class. And for that, I want to say thank you to all of them. And anybody that's interested, get in it. It's the only way to fly.
I'm Matthew DeLong, and I'm amazed at the people that want to help this old man. Dream racing, my dreams come true. Thank you.